Hello, Nader here. Welcome back to Grim Dawn. We're playing with the Ashes of Melmoth expansion with the Necromancer. And we are on our way to Tyrant's Hold. There's a couple of devotion shrines and quests along the way, so plenty of good reasons to go here. In between episodes, I had a look at the different vendors in town, or specifically the different faction vendors, because we're nearly level 35, and level 35 is when you get access to the first tier of items that are faction exclusive. And the rovers have an interesting shoulder pad, so I brought a copy of those along. They give +1 to summon Briarthorn, bit of health, and a nice bonus to the pets. Bunch of damage, bit of health, and a bit of elemental resistance. So I hope that by equipping that, we can make our minions a little sturdier than they normally would be. That's where we're gonna go. But first, let's do a little house cleaning. Oh, hello there, enraged Briarthorns. Very much enraged Briarthorns. Okay. Let's enter. Bloodbriar's lair. Just gonna get a couple of smaller spawns, and in the end, most often Bloodbriar himself is accompanied by a random hero, so it's gonna be a nice fight. Two very angry, very sturdy monsters. This guy's though, they're running away from us, so I guess that makes us the monsters. And just to underscore that, let's rip the spirits from their bodies. And then while the minions wrap up, I'll just focus on the important things. Loot. Here, Bloodbriar, Bloodbriar, Bloodbriar. Where are you? There you are. Wonderful. Okay, let's just boost our minions a little bit. And pop set the weasel. Got a herald's jacket for our troubles. Well, +1 to all skills when you equip all three pieces. So right, it's a mask and jacket, that seems to be a helmet and a body. The ward, have a little difficulty placing that one. Could be a shield, could be amulet for all I care. That is the downside with the sets. Now if you want the set bonus, you do have to equip all the pieces, even if they are individually maybe less good than, say, equipping uniques in those slots would be. Okay, it's a shielded foe. Doesn't help him though. We can just brute force our way through. Did lose a couple skeletons in the process here. This is just so brutal. All the mages. Whereas archers and fleeing foes is actually a nice combination, since now if they run in a straight line, then the bolts will simply just hit them in the back. The meteors being summoned from the sky from the mages is slightly less compatible. That does favor more enemies that stand and fight. Hello there, Ungolianks. Goodbye, Ungolianks. Feels like we never really got the opportunity to get acquainted here. But it doesn't matter. We got loot. And there's a shrine over here. And we do happen to have a serrated spike here. That is wonderful. Oh no, wait! They grab it from your stash now as well. So you don't even have to go back to town to pick things up. That is something that used to be the case, but they did fix it in a patch, actually before the expansion already. Interrogator, plus 3 to the Rune of Calaster, that's an Inquisitor crossbow. So, anything else that is useful here? Where do, let's see, Time Warp. Slowest target, okay. We got ourselves a devotion point, didn't we? Now we should spend it. 100% bonus to vitality decay. And a hefty bonus to both our health as well as that of our minions. So I believe, where was it? It was a vitality decay. Here. 951 vitality decay over 3 seconds for the dread upgrade for Bone Harvest. We're definitely scaling things up nicely. Okay, now we need to find our way out of here. Minimap to the rescue. More spiders. I think there were some spiders popping up behind me. Okay, we are losing some of our skeletons already, simply because we're getting flanked. Well played, spiders, well played. But this is where you'll stop. Oh, we have to actually backtrack a little bit. The way forward goes past here. So the sturdier minions are relatively low on life. They have received quite some punishment. Run, little spiders, run! Mean spirits are out to get you. And we're now friendly with homesteads. Wonderful. That's no one step closer to being able to buy their faction specific items as well. And of course there are new blueprints available. It's, so far every single faction has new blueprints available. Okay, so that resolves this bit, then east is gonna be our next destination, or our next direction. Wonderful. Let's equip our new shoulder pads. We do lose out on a little bit of elemental resist and a little bit of bleeding resist, but those were in pretty good shape. And gaining roughly 200 health, as well as a bonus to no one skill and our pets. I think at this point it is worth it. But when it comes to the resistances, especially though relatively early on in the game, I generally try to just get most of the resistances above 60, and then after that I just try to optimize it by pushing things towards max. But if I then have to make a couple of small sacrifices in some resists in order to boost another stat that I'm low on, or some secondary thing like minion health, then that is a good point, in time at which to make those trade-offs. We gained more skill points, so let's just finish raising this. Might actually have been maxed already, but we're at 19 now, so skeletons have nearly 3,500 health, as well as quite a bit of damage. 3 crossbow, that is nice. Let's just resummon the big minions as well while we're at it. Okay, this road is closed, another wave. 2 mages and a death knight, which casts some form of aura, it seems. So the next skill to max out is going to be the skill that gives us more skeletons. Infantry points gets us a minion there. So then our final number will be 9, so that is conveniently 3 full casts. So now I'm gonna have to recast again, and that is 3 crossbows. Oh no, 2 crossbows and 1 with a big two-handed axe. This looks like a two-handed axe, it's big enough. This is the way forward. Wonderful. Okay, for the devotion shrine, the way it takes us up here, underneath these gates. Demonic solid wormhole. That's a two-hander. It's a bit of chaos damage conversion built in. This one is ruined and wants a scavenge plating and a searing ember. Well, I've got plenty of those in the stash as well. So that is easy peasy. Upgrade. That is another devotion point. So that gets us to this lovely little one. Fatality damage bonus, ether damage bonus, and a massive vitality damage bonus for the pets. Everything should be much more painful now. If we have a look at this, for example, quite a bit of ether damage, that vitality decay is just through the roof. And the Wraith actually has pretty low damage, but it's only a couple levels in. For the skeletons, about half of their damage is vitality based, and we get some unlisted conversion, of course, here. That's going to boost it even further. And the damage on here is also nicely getting along. Excellent. So let's use our newfound strength to clear this fortress. Yeah, calling it a fortress is a little better than calling it a level. Level is such a gamey thing. Ah, a fort. Yes. Still got one item somewhere that gives us a chance when we get hit to cast Earth Ward, giving us quite a bit of health regeneration. And that's definitely one of the nice things about the build in its current state. There are, on the one hand, now our offensive capabilities are pretty insane. So, the best defense is a very good offense. On the other hand, we have life lead, we have some regen, we have some procs that give one or the other. And the end result is that we're doing pretty well in terms of just staying alive. It's only in the most dire of circumstances where we need to make a small tactical withdrawal, recast some minions, apply some control magic like a ill omen or something like that, and then go back into the fray. But we're slowly making our way through the middle section of the old game. So I guess it's technically now still part of the early section of the game, because we have 50% more content due to the expansion. Let's not stand in the spikes over there. Wonderful. It's always the fight with Commander Lucius in Fort Eichen. That's I find that to be a very nice test to see what we're doing, because that is one very dangerous foe. He does a boatload of damage. A lot of the damage he deals is ether based, so it's a good test to see if my resistances are in a good shape. And in Darkvale Village, just before that, of course, we have the Guardian of the Gates that always seems to have just a boatload of health. And if your damage output is a bit on the lower end, then that's a fight that's gonna take ages. If your damage output is on the solid end of the spectrum, then you won't really have too much of an issue there. But yeah, no, just thinking ahead a little bit to the new content. I'm very curious to see how the boss fights are going to perform. And no, how the difficulty there is going to be in relation to what we've had so far. Will the fights be much more elaborate, let's say, as in, no, just to make a small comparison to Path of Exile, which recently also had an expansion that added a lot of new content to the game. In Path of Exile, all of the new boss fights are much more elaborate than some of the oldest boss fights in the game. Now, the old boss fights were pretty simple mechanics. No, they might have had a couple of mechanics, but they were just a single stage, and the boss, generally you could overpower them without really engaging with the mechanics too much. The new boss fights, they have multiple stages, they have specific skills that get used, there's some means to actually break up the different stages to put delays in them and transitions between them. So it feels much more like you're actually having a big fight with a boss that is meaningful and completely different from the normal experience. It's an event unto itself rather than yet another foe that just has a slightly larger health bar. And in Grim Dawn, the boss fights, most of the time the boss fights do feel like it's something of itself. On the one hand, the bosses are much tougher. They have something that's called hero armor. And depending on how important the boss is, it's going to be a higher level of hero armor or boss armor. And some of the effects of boss armor are, they resist a lot of damage. They resist all forms of control magic. Your life leech is going to be severely nerfed against them. So when they hit you, it hurts because they do more damage because they're bosses, right? But your means of regenerating life against them are also severely reduced, as well as they're tougher, so it takes longer to take them out, and their health bars are bigger. So it is, just from that perspective, they are much more difficult to dispatch than normal foes. Pumpwater Creek has two stages, for example. No, he's the man at first, and then he becomes the demonic man, or the ethereal possessed version of the man. So that's a slight upgrade that he gets. No, he's still basically just a big warrior in both stages, or a big knight. Then we have Darius Cronley, who just summons a lot of things and has those crystals and there are lots of minions around him. And just because of that, it's a much more impactful fight. But now the boss dude we're about to face is of the more boring variety, for example. He's just a big dude with a big health bar and nothing really much more to it. Oh, there's no elaborate mechanisms to the fight. It's just he hurts a lot. So if you can tank the hurt he applies, sure, then you can power through it like I'm doing now. Combination of some life leech, some damage reflection, and just generally having lots and lots of minions available to distract the enemy gets me through. And this was a fight I basically could ignore any special mechanics that might have been present in the fight because I could simply overpower him. And in Path of Exile, with the new expansion, all the new boss fights definitely have more stages to them, and it's much more, you need to engage with the mechanics of the fight. And that is a good thing, because it makes the fights more interesting, it makes the bosses feel more impactful. And I'm just thinking ahead to the new content of the Grim Dawn expansion. I'm wondering if we are going to get the same thing from the content here. Whether the devs really took the opportunity to really make the fights nice and impactful. But we'll see. Old Broadbriar is no more. And Ungoliinx is no more. And also, by the way, I've also killed the Global Tyrant for you. So thank you for all the rewards. And we hit level 36. So our race skeleton is now maxed out. I suspected as much. It's nice to see that it was actually true. So next up, Undead Legion. Boosting it So now we have a plus 4 limit, getting us to a total of 8. No, makes sense, because it was 7 before. And let's see, we have a little bit of time remaining. Oh, might as well just go over to Homestead and grab the first waypoint there. Just squish some of the Demepteran eggs. Because of course, it's way too scary to do that for the regular people here. Now, while we're here, might as well just empty our pockets a little bit. Let's see, two-handers, that's an auto-sell since we don't use two-handers. Guns are an auto-sell. This one has a silk swatch I'd like to remove. Bit of chaos resistance, but other than that, not really that great. This one doesn't really... The pet bonus is alright. But that's also kind of it. I'd rather keep the vitality resistance in this regard. And I'm saying it, just really look at what we have here. We have a little bit of vitality damage on the old one, that's ignorable, it's only 8%. The 12% old damage is better. Chaos damage, we don't use it. Bonus to physique, we have quite a lot, so we don't really need to spike it even further in order to equip items. And yeah, we lose a little bit of health, a little bit of regen, but those are things that are gonna vary enough. And boom, well, got ourselves a little bit more physique anyway. Bonus to health, yeah, we would lose a little bit. But the bonus to the minions probably is gonna make up for it, so you know what? We'll just drop this in. Then the sanctified bone. No, but we'll keep this one for later. I'll just flip them in so I can actually move the sanctified bone, things like that. Herald's jacket, no, that's one to keep. All the blue items are to keep. This one looks shiny. Spike Wraith Girdle. Cold damage we don't really use. We do use it a little bit, but not too much. Aether damage, that is something we do have. Vitality resistance, plus 2 to Reap Spirit. And plus 2 to Amarista's Blade Burst. So this is nice if you're playing a Reaper, a Nightblade Necromancer. And a Freezing Nova, 100% chance when hit by melee attacks. Ooh. Freeze targets. Cold damage, 5 meter radius and a 5 second recharge. This is very nice. And I have just a secondary character that would love to equip that one. I've actually just the other day I just started playing a Reaper as well, just to play out a non-minion focused version of the Necromancer, and it is pretty fun to play actually. Let's see, vitality damage, a little bit of health, a little bit of chaos resists. Might be worth considering, especially given that we are giving up some health to switch armors. Getting health back this way might not be too bad. And the gloves, the skill disruption protection and the casting and attack speed are nice, but yeah, it's not stellar, and we've been walking around with it for a while now. A caster helm, energy absorption from spells is actually a nice way to keep refreshing your energy. Is this worth giving up a Earth Ward though? Might be. It does give us some more reliable protections. It's a higher level than we are, it's level 38, so we have a little bit of time to decide on that one. Is the ring any good? Not really. Okay. Let's see, let's go sell that one. Keep this one with his friends.
Hey, good cool. Use.
Let's move forward. Let's grab one more waypoint. We now have a small army running along with us, so must take it for a spin. Time to squish some bugs. Ooh, wonderful. The minions are shooting at the eggs for us, so we don't have to click on all of them. That's nice. Definitely a nice upside to having an army of minions. Yeah, I think this might be very nice progression. They're dead before they crawl out of the floor. That is very convenient. Okay. There's more. Okay. The more minions we get, the more I'm liking this. That is 9 out of 10. And there's one more. Probably going to be on this field. Ooh, a unique. Or a hero. Well. Eye of the Beholder. Let's see. Chaos damage, poison damage. So that's a bit of a mismatch. I do like the eye that sits on top of the hat. It looks really nice. Spirit, bit of energy regen, so that would be useful. Gaze weakness, toggled ability, costs some energy, basically just takes away the energy bonus we just got from it. And it just gives a 6% offensive ability bonus to all of our buddies. Alright. It's a bit of a mismatch for us. But we did unlock the graphics for the illusionist, so we can at least put it on our head looks wise. Because sometimes that is all that matters. We still have all 8 of our skeletons with us. That is a nice surprise. Oh, shouldn't be too much of a surprise given the fact that most of the Maptrams have been killed right where they stood before they could even, well, sometimes crawl out of the floor. Ruined Shrine, that's gonna be a mutagenic ichor. Wonderful, another point, and I think that completes the typhus for us, because there's another thing on his other arm. Bit of physical resistance, which is nice. So, typhus gives us purple. So that means we can actually refund the purple starter. And then the next journey is going to be focus on a green. And I think that was the bat. It might have been the... Oh no, it was the raven, because that's also green. Raven has some energy bonuses, which are going to be convenient. As well as some pet damage bonuses. So all in all, that's going to be pretty nice. Also, stop shooting at my pets. They are not defending themselves when I'm not paying attention to them. Silly worms. Okay. Well, ethereals, they are all over the place. They're like rats. Oh, especially in this case. No, they're hiding in barns. It's a very rat-like thing to do. Last will of Marthas Everbrook. Wonderful. So that's a bit of a lore bonus. There was a hidden treasure. Here be written the last will and decree of the late Marthas Anthony Everbrook II. To my daughter, dearest Lizzie, I leave the farmstead and its surrounding orchards. Let the land which has blessed our family with harvest for generations continue to provide for you and your children. And now, to my bull-headed sons, Edric and Anthony, you have filled my remaining years with your endless bickering over whom would inherit my fortune. To you, I leave nothing but these words. I had the farmhands bury the gold somewhere on the Everbrook lands. You now have but 2 options. Move on with your miserable lives and start anew through back-breaking labor, just as your grandfather did before you. Or squander your youth searching for that which you do not deserve. I trust you will make the right decision. Along the bottom you can barely make out some scribbled notes in a different handwriting. In the hills, up the road from Thornsbury's, bring explosives. So that points us to a secret. But we were not here for the secrets. No, they're a nice bonus, but we were not there. Not here for that. Specifically, we were here for the portal. We now have it, so that is good. I think Thornsbury, wasn't that one of the farms up? Back up there. Or was it down? Oh, let's roam around a little bit to see if you can discover it, where the treasure is hiding. Usually not that great at puzzles, and I don't remember where this one was exactly, so that's definitely not helping. Oh, there's a unique in there. Oh, there. Here, have yourself a spirit. And please be gone. Wonderful. More reputation with homestead, that is always nice. This looks rather hilly. I might be heading. This is definitely hilly, right? In the hills, up the road from Thornsbury's. So could this be that this was the Thornsbury Farms? Let's just have a quick look. This is, no, there's no obvious secrets to the sides, but let's just trace back our steps before we're getting completely lost in the woods. There are plenty of farms around there, and plenty of enemies to kill along the way. Nice little bridge. Elmsworth Farm. Okay. Guess that's different than a Thornsbury Farm. Okay, then there was something up there. Can have a quick check over there. This is the Thornsbury Farm. Okay. So from Thornsbury to the hills. Data's diary, that's another quest. She's got some interesting nighttime adventures. Okay, so from over here to Thornsbury, then I would say the road just stretches on, right? And then here we do have hills, but this is also kind of just leading us back to town. That doesn't really make a lot of sense. The secrets in the game, most of the time they're pretty well hidden, just visually. On the other hand, this is still the Thornsbury Farm. I would say this is still rather hilly as far as environments go. Because now it's Elmsworth. So that would be the competitor, I would say. So let's double check. In the hills, up the road from Thornsbury, bring explosives. Especially, we have cleared most of the things here already. Maybe in that bit. here we're just veering off to the side. Ooh, beasts are now hating me. That does have some implications. We get additional hero spawns, which is always a good thing. Since the more hero spawns we get, the more XP and loot we're gonna get from them. Okay, there's some very ominous background noises that are triggering here. Okay, so this is, once again, it is hilly over here. Lots of creepy blinking lights in there. This is where we found the book. So it's interesting to see what they mean with certain clues. So now if it's up the road, is it then from this perspective towards them and then just stretching beyond, or would it be more the other way around, so looking from Homestead, the farm, and then looking further towards a hill of sorts? But given the fact that we didn't really find anything there, let's just see if we can move over a little bit. Oh, hello there, hero spawn. Beastkin Eater Corrupted. Wonderful. There's a crumbling wall here with a lot of stuff, some hidden remains. Still haven't had to use any dynamite here, so don't think that's good, but we did get a nice bunch of loot from that. Nice bunch of green items. You see, still hills over there. And there's no consider the game is just packed chock full of little things like that. In this game they're just explicitly telling you, hey, there is something, go look for it. But a lot of things they don't have such, well, quote unquote, obvious clues pointing at them. And then it's just up to you to either find them or not. Okay, this looks, again, rather hilly. But I doubt this is where they wanted us to go. So then would it be the hills in the south where the grobles hide? Because there are groble camps down there. You know what, I don't think this randomly wandering around is gonna do all that good. No, we're gonna check out the grobble areas in the south. And if that does not it, then I'm gonna give up for now. But yeah, these are definitely the most obvious hills, even though they are past the Elmsworth farm instead of the Ornate Strongbox. Sorry, getting distracted by loot. At least that loot we can find. Okay, yeah, this is gonna be painful to run through, but we can do it. Wonderful. No terrain damage like that, from what I understand, there's no real way to defend yourself against it. Since it seems to ignore just your resistances. So you can use life regeneration and damage mitigation as a means to reduce some of it or reduce the impact of it, but eventually it is gonna wear you down. Okay, bunch of good stuff. So that's yet more of the map that has been uncovered here. Okay, maybe something over here. Oh, look at that, another secret. Might not be the secrets that we're specifically looking for, but we keep finding lots and lots of secrets in places. This is one of the main reasons why I really do like Grim Dawn. Since the world is just so well designed, there's just so many things to find, so many things to do. And now I've played at least 5 or 6 different characters throughout the entirety of the old story. So that's the first 4 acts of the story, as well as taking some of them through Elite and Ultimate difficulty. So I've gone through the story quite a bit, and there's just places that I keep forgetting about, or some things that I just might not even have seen. But yeah, so this is definitely not where the treasure is. Though there's a different secret here. So let's end this by doing a different secret than the one we intended. We do need dynamite for this. But this is not, should not be the hidden secret that we are looking for. Even though, no, the combination of we are in the hills and we have a detonation site here. It's there's a bit of a link, but this is slightly different than expected. It's a buried crypt here. And there's a child in a buried crypt. How did you get trapped down here? Yeah, they want to get out. I tried doing that once. The people outside were not really happy with it. So let's see if we can just ask a little bit more. So how did you come down here? Well, it's kind of odd that you survived by yourself down here, didn't you? Something is definitely off here. Ooh, and then the flames flicker in Callista's eyes. Take me from this place now! And turns out, little girl was actually a demon. Oh, killing demons. We can do that. We got some blood of Katon. Nice crafting material. And that deals with that. We did lose 2 skeletons in the process. Ooh, we got a Death Knight. Wonderful. And then I think the folks in town, they're not really gonna give us lots and lots of rewards for it. But it's nice to just do a little bit of aftercare, let them know that their daughter is dead and no longer being haunted by a demon. So you're happy now, and okay, so now they are happy and they're still alive. Because if you release Callista, things end slightly less good for them. Let's keep it to that. A crumbling wall. It's interesting that there's a crumbling wall, but there's just stones around it, so it doesn't really help you all that much. Just more things to murder. But I can just keep playing this all day, and probably I will keep playing this all day, but episodes do need to have an ending. So let's wrap this up properly. Let's go to town, hand in the quests, and then I promise you we're gonna end this episode, because it's been going on for way too long. So we have Douglas here, cleared out the fields. Wonderful. So yeah, we'll take out the queen for you. That is something for next episode. And then over here, we up there we have a Dela Thornsbury, whose diary we found. I found your diary, and your secret is safe with me. Boom. It would be improper to lie. Okay, and with that we have done everything I am gonna do for this episode. So I'm gonna thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again next time. Bye bye.